service of comfort and hope, and we're glad you're here, whether you're inside the sanctuary with us tonight or whether you are participating online. We are glad, so glad that you're here. We want to thank especially the ones who prepared the candles and the ornaments for us tonight. We want to thank Carolyn Simpson and Dana Adams for preparing the ornaments, and Scott and Kim Bean for preparing the candles for us. The large candles represent church members or attendees of those who've gone on before us this past year. The small candles will represent all of those people that you might write down on the little sheet, the little card. If you didn't get to write down someone that you want to remember, please go on back to the foyer and you may do that, and Jody will be bringing me those later, those memory cards. But tonight is a night to remember. To remember your loved ones who've gone before us. It's a time to treasure precious memories and to ponder those memories in our heart. It's also a time to be deliberate in thanking God for those memories. And if you have memories that you don't want to remember or you know you need to release, tonight is the night to release those as well. Give them to God. Let God bring you comfort this evening through the singing of Christmas music, through reflecting on His Word together and lighting candles and praying together. Let us pray. Father, we certainly are grateful to be in your house. Father, we're grateful for this time that we can beseech you on behalf of these, our church members, who've lost loved ones to death this past year. Father, we thank you so much for those saints that have gone to be with you. Father, we thank you for the release that was given to so many of them for just the difficult time they were having on this earth. And Father, we thank you for them being able to be face to face with you and to rejoice with you. Father, thank you that we have the means to worship with those who are participating online tonight too. But thank you, O God, for the way that you take care of us. In Christ's name we pray. Amen.
Thank you. Before I sing this song, I wanted to share a little bit of the background on it. This was one of those songs, I'd never heard it before, and I heard it in my car on the radio, and I just had to find out what it was. And as I did my research and looked online, I found this background information that Francesca Battistelli herself had given, and this is what she writes. The story behind this song is an unexpected one. Truth be told, this song was written, recorded, and about to be sent to radio for Christmas 2019. But at the last minute, God put a major check on my heart. So much so, we pushed pause on this song and on a Christmas EP. Honestly, it was disheartening to have a song like this one ready to release and feel like God was putting the brakes on it. But even with the confusion and disappointment, I felt the Lord give me a divine reassurance that this song in some way and somehow was meant for someone in the coming year. Little did I know in that moment over a year ago the things that would transpire in our country, in our world, and in our communities. In 2020, we have experienced loss together, some deeper and wider than others, but we have all been forced to face disappointments, sit with unmet expectations, and even experience excruciating loneliness and sadness. These troubles, while uncomfortable, remind us even more so that this world is not our home. It is in these uncertain times that we turn our eyes to the comfort and security of a God who does not look away from our suffering. And then she closes with John 16:33. I have told you these things so that in me you may have peace. In this world you will have trouble, but take heart. I have overcome the world.
She put up the tree, stockings 1, 2, 3, they all know one is missing. It's been a without him right here, won't be the same kind of Christmas. Some years it's wonder and lights in the sky. Some years it's okay to cry. In your silent night, when you're not all right, lift your eyes and be. Come home empty-handed.
I'll be reading 2 Corinthians chapter 1, verses 3 through 7. Praise be to the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of compassion and the God of all comfort, who comforts us in all our troubles so that we can comfort those in any trouble with the comfort we ourselves receive from God. For just as we share abundantly in the sufferings of Christ, so also our comfort abounds through Christ. If we are distressed, it is for your comfort and salvation. If we are comforted, it is for your comfort, which produces in you patient endurance of the same sufferings we suffer. And our hope for you is firm, because we know that just as you share in our sufferings, so also you share in our comfort.
We respond to that text by singing the gospel hymn, No, Not One.
Save.
please join me in reading responsively the reading 678, Advent. Comfort ye my people, saith your God.
The voice of him that crieth in the wilderness, prepare ye the way of the Lord, make straight in the desert a highway for our God.
And the glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all flesh shall see it together, for the mouth of the Lord hath spoken it.
He shall feed his flock like a shepherd. He shall gather the lambs with his arm and carry them in his bosom, and shall gently lead those that are with young.
This is God's word for the people of God this evening. O come, Emmanuel, a prayer. Let's sing together.
Come, thou wisdom from
during this time of candle lighting, instead of you coming forward, we're going to have you just stand where you are, and Steve is going to be down front, and he's going to light the candles. And we will start first with the names of the church members or attendees or the spouses of members who have died this past year. When I read your loved one's name, please stand, and then Steve will light that candle. The first is Randy Fisher, February the 16th, 2020. The next is Mo Sams, February the 26th. Clara Arnold, March the 9th. Junie Rout, May the 20th. Janet Miller, would you please stand? Jim, we pray for you as you stand in memory of your wife. Thank you. Thank you. Now, Liz Fox, June the 13th. Liz's daughter, Lily, is watching online. She's out of town in a show. Jack Briscoe, June the 22nd. Ron Pope, June the 25th. Pat Newton, July 13th. George Stapleton, July 17th. Courtney Callahan, August the 2nd. We have Kenny and Xavier and Lorenza Callahan standing in memory of daughter and mother. Thank you. Kara DeJanes, August 31st. Dottie Lanham, September 17th. Emery Hobbs, September 22nd. His wife, Betty, daughter, Leslie, son-in-law, Danny, standing in memory of him. Thank you. Geneva Garner, mother of Nancy Shoemaker, mother-in-law of Phil Shoemaker, who are standing in memory of her. Thank you. Scott Crittenden, mother Bev Crittenden, standing in memory of Scott. Thank you. Gloria Freeman, November 28th, standing in her memory, her daughter-in-law, Charlotte Miles Freeman. Margaret Ann Durham, standing in her memory is Carolyn Simpson, who is doing so for the family. I think she's in the cry room, standing for the family. All of them are out of town. Terry Pearson, December 10th. We are grateful for these saints who have gone before us. We remember them. We pray for the families. And we don't want to let those memories ever leave our minds, sweet and precious memories. And many more of you have memories as well for other folks. Sharon Kelly. Sharon, you want to stand in memory of her father, Ray Curtis. Then another candle for Walter Rice. And for Lottie Rice. And then Timmy Perdue, Shayla's boyfriend. Then her neighbor, Ann Smith, whose husband died right after Christmas last year. And Carolyn Simpson stands in memory of these loved ones. Vanda and Coleman Simpson, her parents. Royce Simpson, her brother. Thelma and Kurt Mingadote, her sister and brother-in-law. Velma and James Smith, another sister and brother-in-law. Then Norma Rout stands in memories of Sanja Grass, of John Cottrell, of Eva Rout, of Mildred Lynch, and James Rout. And then Charlotte Freeman stands in memory of her brother, Mike Miles, in memory of her mother, Betty Miles. Nettie and Steve Hale stand in memory of Ernie Adams and of Charlie Cook. Jody Toll stands in memory of her parents, Ray and Carol Johnson, and her sister, Connie Hall. Michelle Kreider stands in memory of her brother, Fred Kreider. Marcy Callahan, thank you, Marcy, stands in memory of Cindy Mitchell, her sister, and of Jackie Mitchell. Marilyn Calvert stands in memory of Garnet McDonald, Glenn's aunt that died yesterday at 97 years old. Joy Stelly stands in memory of Glenn and Inez Duhan. Keith and Terry Bosmer stand in memory of their parents, Howard Fought, Hazel Bosmer, and Ralph Bosmer. Now Nancy Shoemaker stands in memory of a friend, Ryan Hornsley. Then George Popham stands in memory of his sister, Joyce Murray. As you see these candles before you, remember. Remember the good things. And we'll spend a few minutes in silent prayer before Steve's solo. And Bev Crittenden for Daryl Crittenden. Sorry, I didn't say it again. I think I passed right by that one. Bev Crittenden, in memory of Daryl Crittenden. Thank you. Let us pray silently until Steve sings.
shelter of the Lord, who abide in his shadow for life. Say to the Lord, my refuge, my rock in whom I trust, and he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand. The snare of the fowler will never capture you, and famine will bring you no fear. Under his wings, your refuge, his faithfulness, your shield, and he will raise you wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand. Nor the arrow that flies by day. Nor thousands fall about you. Near you it shall not come. And he will raise you up on him. Wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand. For to his angels he's given a command to guard you in all of your ways. Upon their hands they will bear you up, lest you dash your foot against the stone. And he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of God, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you, and hold you, and hold you in the palm of his hand.
Amen. Matthew 1:23 says, "The virgin Mary will be with child and give birth to a son and will call him Emmanuel," which means God with us. As we said this morning, over 600 years before this scripture became reality, Isaiah prophesied to King Ahaz, "Therefore the Lord himself will give you a sign. The virgin will be with child and will give birth to a son and will call him Emmanuel." Yes, this prophecy was fulfilled with the birth of Jesus. And Matthew says that Jesus is the ultimate fulfillment of that prophecy. The name Emmanuel reminds us of the constant presence of God in our lives. Maybe we don't always feel his presence, but we do know his presence. We don't know sometimes what's going on around us. We feel uncertain. Sometimes life even feels overwhelming, but we do know, if we are in Christ, that he never leaves us. Each time we reflect on the baby in the manger, we remember that God is with us. He also reminds us in Hebrews 13:5 and Deuteronomy 31:6, "Never will I leave you, never will I forsake you." Jesus is God with us. Jesus is God with us in the flesh. Jesus is the fulfillment of God's promise. The promise of God with us is still reality today. John 14:16-18. "And I will ask the Father, and he will give you another counselor to be with you forever, the Spirit of truth. The world cannot accept him because it neither sees him nor knows him. But you know him, for he lives with you, and he'll be with you. I will not leave you as orphans. I will come to you." Jesus, Emmanuel, continues to be with us through the Holy Spirit and will be with us forever. For many of you, surrounding the deaths of your loved ones, there are lots of unanswered questions. When there are unanswered questions, Emmanuel is with us. When the road of life is difficult, Emmanuel is with us. When our hearts are aching, and they seem to even be breaking, Emmanuel is with us. When times are tough, Emmanuel is with us. When we face death during a pandemic, Emmanuel is with us and with our loved ones. When we look into the future without our loved ones, Emmanuel is with us. During uncertain and scary financial difficulties or fiscal cliffs, Emmanuel is with us. When everyone around us seems to have gone, Emmanuel is with us. In the ordinary moments of life, Emmanuel is with us. When we feel like we want to quit, Emmanuel is with us. And when we have big decisions to make, especially after the death of those loved ones, Emmanuel is with us. When we need wisdom and direction, Emmanuel is with us. When no one seems to understand, Emmanuel is with us. When we are physically distanced and isolated, Emmanuel is with us. When we can't hug each other, Emmanuel is with us. When we need comfort and strength and hope, Emmanuel is with us. And also when we're joyous and hopeful, Emmanuel is with us. These holidays have been tough for many of you. Losing a loved one to death during this year, and many of you right during this Thanksgiving and Christmas season. Celebrating Christmas for the first time without a loved one. Celebrating, realizing that there is an empty chair, a missing person around the table. Dealing with what is ahead for you or your family. And these days of pandemic have made life even more difficult. God is with you during these situations. Emmanuel is God's promise that you don't have to be alone. He is with you in the valley of the shadow of death, and he will transform your valley, and he will bring light and hope, and he will hold you in the palm of his hand. You know, Emmanuel is with us, driving to work or working. Emmanuel is with us, sleeping. Emmanuel is with us when we're awake. Emmanuel is with us when we're locked up in our homes. Emmanuel is with us when we're watching television or shopping. Emmanuel is with us in our silent nights that Kristen sang. And Emmanuel is with us when we're just not all right. Emmanuel is with us right now, and he's not about to leave. And that's the promise. God loves us so much that he became one of us. He came to live among us so that we might one day live with him. Of course, in his coming to live among us, we get to choose whether we accept his love, whether we accept his comfort, or whether we accept his salvation. He offers it, but we choose whether to accept it. He doesn't force himself upon us because he loves us so much, but he offers the invitation to become his children. And we do that by accepting Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior. Say those wonderful words that you said with me this morning. God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. That everlasting life leads us to heaven. Jesus said, let not your heart be troubled. Ye believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions, and if it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you, and if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there you may be also. We hope all of you here will accept Emmanuel, Jesus Christ, as your Savior if you've not already done so. Because for those who are in Christ, there are no goodbyes. It's just see you later. Some of your loved ones actually said words like that before they departed this earth. They told you about the peace that they had and looked forward to who they were going to see as well. But you know, yes, we get to see those in Christ face to face, but best of all, we get to see Jesus Christ face to face. While we still live in this land of tears, Charles Swindoll gives this advice. He says, if you want to smile through your tears, if you want to rejoice through times of suffering, just keep reminding yourself that what you're going through is not the end of the story. It's simply the rough journey that leads to the right destination. And praise God, life on this earth is not the final destination. The Apostle Paul also reminds us that when we go through all of this suffering on this earth, as bad as it may be, as horrific as that suffering might be, it pales in comparison to the overwhelming and amazing glory that we will one day experience when we see Jesus face to face. When we get to the destination of heaven, we'll truly understand what the psalmist said when he wrote these words, weeping may remain for a night, but rejoicing comes in the morning. But while we live on this earth, Emmanuel is a reminder of the hope and the presence of Jesus Christ. Matthew's gospel ends with these words, and lo, I'm with you always, even unto the ends of the earth. Emmanuel, God with us. Emmanuel will give you the strength to make it through the valley of the shadow of death. Emmanuel will turn your weeping into dancing. Emmanuel will give you a vision of God's future glory. Behold him. God is with you. God is with us. Rest in his presence and reflect upon his words as Joellen and Karen play the beautiful music of Hallelujah. Let us meditate. Thank you. After the benediction, we invite you to come meet Steve and me at the front, and we'll bag up your candles for you so that you may take them, and you'll want to make sure to meet Carolyn out at the tree and get your ornament as well. Let's pray. Father, Jesus, Holy Spirit, Emmanuel, thank you that you are with us. Father, we know that the pain, as we look out here, that the pain is so great. For many who are right here and online with us, but Father, we know that Emmanuel with us can ease the pain, can turn weeping into rejoicing, and turn sackcloth into beautiful new garments. And Father, we look forward today that we are face to face with those who have gone before us in Christ. But we look forward to when we see you face to face. In Christ's name we pray. Amen.
Let's stand and sing together, Emmanuel.